Hello everyone, friends, on the Software Developer blog, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like this video. Today we will talk about whether it is worth learning PHP, or it is already unnecessary and is not used anywhere. Therefore, I decided to record this video to reveal this topic in more detail. In fact, many beginners are interested in this programming language, because it's really easy to get started. PHP has a low knowledge input proc, but this leaves its mark on all common PHP-related points. The thing is that PHP syntax is very simple. This is certainly not Python, but most of the functions are intuitive and use a convenient notation. Much of what turned out to be complex and archaic in syntax has been resolved and changed in newer versions of PHP. Of course, the fastest way to learn PHP is if you are already familiar with the basics of programming in another language. For example, if you have already learned C++ or Java, then switching to PHP will be very easy. In fact, the PHP programming language is popular due to its scalability, huge community support, open source, and a number of other reasons. And there is no doubt that for the development, dynamic websites, preference is given to this particular programming language. If you need to create a small site or develop a CMS for the specific requirements of a client, then PHP and its CMS systems are the best choice. The most commonly used is WordPress. For online stores, opencart, magento are suitable. But when it comes time to pay more attention to security, architecture, speed, and powerful functionality, this is already worth paying attention to. To various PHP frameworks. Most often it is Laravel or Symfony. Of course, PHP is not as popular as JavaScript, but it easily enters the 10 most popular and popular programming languages at the moment. PHP is very popular on freelance. Many who want to work from freelance choose PHP, thanks to the projects that are written in it and ease of earning. Almost anyone can now learn WordPress and sign up for freelance. Make up a theme, connect modules, reconfigure templates, write a plugin, all this will not be very difficult and does not require a dozen years of experience. If you have no experience and do not know more than one programming language and you want to learn PHP, do not undertake to read a lot of theory at the initial stage. When you read it, you will only lose the desire to study something. It will be much more useful and interesting for you to read a more detailed theory only after writing the code. Go straight to practice, set yourself tasks and try to solve them. To begin with, set a very small one, for example, calculate and display how much 5 plus 5 will be. Then, for example, display all the data in the array, etc. Start with small tasks. If you still like the reader of literature, then I can advise you a few books. The first is PHP 7. PHP 7 is the most complete guide, and also in-app development with PHP and MySQL. This book is intended for people who already have some programming experience from those familiar with HTML. Otherwise, everything is perfectly described in the official documentation on the PHP website. You can learn from it, the result will be the same. After you learn the basics of the PHP language, you should move on to learning the framework. At the moment, I recommend learning Laravel or Symfony. In general, frameworks are designed to facilitate and speed up development. Therefore, at the first stage, do not be afraid and know that it will take you time to understand the essence of the framework and understand it. Thanks to the documentation, everything is well described, and there are plenty of examples on the internet. Remember that the most important thing is practice. The more we'll practice, the faster you will be able to learn PHP. And that's all I have. Thank you all for your attention. See you soon.